Good evening and welcome to a rainy football night on Friday night at Kirkwood High School, raining all over the area for the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week. Tonight, it's the Kirkwood Pioneers hosting the Parkway North Vikings, both teams highly ranked in the state, and it should be a terrific game tonight. Good evening, everybody. Harry Schrader, Isaac Bird. We'll be joined by Angela Sharp in just a little bit. The Kirkwood Pioneers, one of the top three teams in the state in Class 6. Parkway North, top two or three teams in Class 4. It should be a great game tonight between these two stellar broad teams.
I'm expecting a very good game today. Parkway North comes in with a 4-0 record led by a defense that's only giving up 4 points a game. Now, they're going against an offense that is struggling to put up points against good teams.
Proven coaches on both sides, and let's talk about some of the key players tonight. First, the Elite Football Academy player to watch is the quarterback from Kirkwood, Reese Goddard.
Goddard sure does look the part, doesn't he? 6'1", 210 pounds. He's a big, strong-armed quarterback. He's your prototypical pro-style quarterback that has the ability to make some plays with his legs. And on third down, he'll roll out and complete some passes downfield as well.
He ran for over 900 yards last year. He can do it all. On the other side, Luke Hertzler, more of a pocket passer for Parkway North.
Luke Hertzler is probably the best deep ball thrower that I've seen all year. He's very smart. He reads defenses very well. And he has a very good knack of getting the ball out of his hands and getting it downfield completed right before he gets hit. If he's on, Parkway North is going to be very tough to beat today. And he's been on all year.
Parkway North undefeated. Kirkwood just one loss, and both of them highly ranked in the state. It's a conference game for both of them. It should be a great night tonight. It's soggy. Kirkwood High School. We'll be back in just a minute with the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week.
I was sick of working dead-end jobs. I wanted to have a career. Battle Eye gave me the hands-on experience to build my future. Them teachers were very good.
The purpose of them coming to Battle Eye is to learn a trade. As an instructor, I'm gonna be there for them.
They just made me feel like a brand new person.
He's been working with me for some years, and I'm proud of him and the things that they have instilled in him.
I want to follow in my dad's footsteps, but now I figured out through Battle Eye, I could be better than my dad. Battle Eye had really changed my life.
Parkway North won the Lions Choice coin toss. They elected to defer. Kirkwood will get the ball, go right to left here as we start this first half. And, boy, this is an explosive Kirkwood team. I was talking with head coach Bob Bunton last night, and I said they've got home run hitters. He said they've got about seven home run hitters. They're really concerned about being able to contain the speed of Kirkwood High School. Kirkwood sends a number of players deep, one of them Joe Jordan, number two. And trying to make out the number of the other young man. Difficult to see from our angle. I think it's Mosby, but we'll wait and see. Ferrin gets ready to put a foot into it and does, and it is very high and it is very deep, and it'll be a touchback. And it was Mosby back there. And so the Pioneers will start at their own end after the touchback. And Isaac, they've got speed all over the place, but we talked about Reese Goddard at the open. He's only run for 100 yards in their first four games, but ran for 940 last year. And a ton of touchdowns and a ton of passing yards. The guy can do everything.
Yeah, and Aris is doing a good job sitting in the pocket and making plays with his arm. We know he's a great athlete. He can pull the ball down and run on third down and pick up the first down. But he's doing a really good job this year throwing the ball from the pocket.
They had to replace three or four guys on the offensive line this year. That was kind of the big question mark coming in because they do have talent everywhere. Goddard will run on first down, short gain, and we send it to our sideline reporter, Angela Sharp.
Hey there, Harry and Isaac. I'm down here in the sidelines of Kirkwood cheerleaders out here trying to get the spirit. Now, you guys mentioned earlier, not a lot of people going to be in the stands due to the rain. That means our Lions Choice family of the game, even that much cooler because they're out here bearing the weather. I'm going to find them a little bit later. And you can always watch us streaming live at KSCK.com. And you can check us out on Sunday morning on KPLR. Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
Kern blitzing off the edge, sacked. Reese Goddard, it'll set up a fourth down for the Pioneers.
Yeah, Reese looked to the right. He had man-to-man. I thought he'd go ahead and pull the trigger. He has to understand that if he really doesn't have time to scan the entire field of going against this defense. As you see, the blitz right off the edge, looks right, pumps it. Once he brings it down, he's got to make a better decision, either to run that ball quickly or just throw it away.
Ivan Barnett puts a foot into it. It'll come down about the 50 and giving ground. All the way back to the 45 and hauled down right down at the midfield stripe. That's McMiller returning it. And we're going to Parkway North will have great field position. Telecast made possible tonight, and we're grateful for the support of We Do Laundry and their support of high school football. We do laundry. I don't, but they do. We do laundry. So again, great field position for the Vikings. Went three and out last time. Take it one way, go the other, trying to a little bit of misdirection and a short pickup. Neither team with a lot going on just yet. That was Ryan Smith on the carry and a pickup of a couple.
Well, the team that gets a good running game going is the team that's going to have the advantage. Bad weather is the ultimate equalizer. It doesn't matter if you have more talent on your team against the team you're facing. When the weather is bad, it really brings both teams together. So with the rain coming, you may not see a lot of deep balls. You may not see a lot of completions today. So the focus is going to be offensive line, ground game. Whoever gets that ground game going is going to have an advantage.
Hertzler is back. Under pressure, hit as he throws, and it's incomplete. And, boy, was he pounded, and he's not getting up very quickly. He is still bent over. He took it right under the chin. And he's trying to figure out if he's still awake. But he pops up. He's looking over the sideline to try to get the play. Or maybe, yeah, he's trying to get the play, and we'll watch it again. The Harris Stowe replay.
He wants to go long here as he's looking down the field, gets a good grip, and right when he sets to throw it, he gets hit and hit hard.
As yeah, Ivan Barnett.
Barnett came right up the middle.
And you know, I was wrong there. He didn't get it under the chin. It was a shoulder-to-shoulder shot.
It was a good hit.
Yeah.
It was a good legal hit. The refs did a good job not throwing the flag there.
And it looks like the Vikings have jumped this time. Nope, called a timeout. Hey, this telecast made possible through the support of Me to You Game Truck. Let our luxury video game truck be a part of your next party. I need to hook up with the Me to You Game Truck. And this one's wobbling off the side of his foot. It's going to land at about the 30, but it takes a Parkway North bounce inside the 20 to about the 15-yard line. Ends up being about a 40-yard punt, no return. This telecast is made possible by the support of Microsoft, helping people and businesses realize their full potential. So now it's second and a bunch, second and 17. Under 3 minutes to go here in the quarter, and Goddard will roll left and pump fake, and now he's going to keep it himself up to the near the 10-yard line and driven out of bounds right there. Boy, great discipline and pursuit by Parkway North. Jelani Williams drives him out of bounds.
And that's a good job by Goddard. Fakes to the right, rolls to the left. They're trying to get a quick dump-off pass towards the sideline just to get a little bit of room. As you see there, he's looking for number two. Doesn't like it for some reason. Pulls it down. That's okay. Try to pick up some positive yards and then get out of bounds. This isn't the area of the field where you want to turn the ball over. So if you're not 100% sure as a quarterback to throw that ball, don't throw it. Pull it down and run in. That's what he did.
Give Goddard three, third and 14. 2:51 to go, and it looked like the Pioneers jumped again.
Yes, he did.
This has got to be driving Farrell Shelton crazy.
I think it was the guard, the left guard, number 62, if I'm not mistaken.
The center moved the ball.
I've never seen that before. Not only did he want to snap it early, but it was a fake snap.
Tyler Peck just moved the ball too quickly, and Goddard lifts it way over everybody just to get rid of it, and it's fourth down. And boy, the Pioneers have really struggled. They're much better than this. Stay tuned. You're still going to see good Pioneer football tonight. but it's been a bad start for them so far.
Yeah, it's been a sloppy start on both sides of the ball, really, or at least for both teams. But you almost kind of expect it with the weather being so bad. It's an early start. Everyone's out of their routine.
That's not the regular routine is just completely shot.
Absolutely. So, but it's early. It's early still. I still think it's going to be some really, really good plays and some football being played.
Barnett's almost blocked. He gets it off high. McMiller wants the fair catch at the 41-yard line. Best field position of the night for the Vikings, who have had great field position on every possession but haven't been able to move the ball. Tonight's telecast is brought to you in part by Millennium Restoration and Development, restoring neglected buildings throughout the St. Louis region. Third and three for the Vikings, and, well, they decided to jump. And that'll drive them backwards. Boy, Butler was 4 or 5 yards down the field before anybody hit him last time. Great work by those guys up front in Parkway North.
Yeah, and that's where it's going to have to start tonight. I may not be a lot of throws. If there are some touchdown throws, it may be some short passes, and then a guy just breaks a tackle and run down the sideline. That's another fake snap. I've never saw it one time. Now this is twice in 10 minutes. Incredible.
Tough on the big guys tonight so far. First penalty of the night against the Vikings. And it's third and about eight. From the gun, Hertzler, he's going to get hit again, and he is sacked in the backfield by Telfair. Chased down by Barnett, tackled by Telfair, and it'll be fourth down again, another three and out.
Boy, this Kirkwood defense has come to play tonight, and they've been in bad situations every single position, playing on with their backs up against the wall, but they haven't budged one bit yet in this first quarter.
Telfair already has three tackles here in the opening quarter. He's been terrific. And Farron's kick is high. And it will come down at about the 15. Oh, and then it takes a Kirkwood bounce out about the 21-yard line. That one checked up and went backwards, and that's not what Mr. Farron wanted. But the Pioneers will start at the 21-yard line. We want to give our thanks to Wynn, one of our great sponsors. Tonight's telecast brought to you in part by Noodles & Company. The crew was eating this afternoon. Isaac and I and
so
Angela,
good.
We went down and ate
Absolutely.
Some as well. Real food, real cooking, real flavors. They have locations all around the metro St. Louis area. That's some of the stuff you were eating. I was having
was
some of that
so
macaroni.
Good. Absolutely.
Cookies were pretty good, right?
I'm getting hungry now.
On first down, Goddard will run left, get to the line of scrimmage, and a little bit more out near the 25, maybe the best play of the night so far for the Pioneers.
Now, this is what Goddard can do. Big, strong kid. He doesn't mind, you know, sticking his nose right in there in the defensive line area. And he's also a good enough athlete to where he's got the speed to get around the edge and make some yards. So with this night being the way it is, the rain is coming down, it looks like you're going to need to run the ball more. Look for Kirkwood to put the ball in Goddard's hand and tell him to run some.
First quarter's in the books. No score. Kirkwood hosting Parkway North on the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week.
When Chris graduates with his liberal arts degree, his starting salary is $25,000. That's if he can find a job. When Steve graduates from MTC Truck Driving School, he'll work for a national company at $50,000 a year. Which route would you take? Hop on at beatrucker.com.
It's the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week. No score after one quarter here at Soggy Kirkwood. And let's send it down to our Angela Sharp.
I have just a quick game update. Before Kirkwood's offensive line went out there, assistant coach took him aside, told them if they keep making mistakes, they're going to lose this game. He singled out his seniors in particular so they get their heads in the game. They pumped each other up, went out there. Let's see if they can turn something around.
Talked about Joe Jordan, 13 yards rushing coming into the game, leading them in receptions with 15. Has about a 15, 16-yard run earlier in this game. And other than Joe Jordan, there hasn't been a lot of offense for Kirkwood just yet. Goddard, little swing pass out to the side. This is Clay. 35 and across the 30-yard line. Short gain there. Let's send it to our sideline reporter, Angela Sharp.
Hey there. I have Napoleon Williams III with Connections to Success with me down here. Who does Connections to Success help?
We help everyone. So traditionally, we assist individuals from challenging backgrounds. But since we've evolved by being founded in 1998, we've been assisting individuals from various backgrounds. Right now, I want to give a call to action to our high schools. We have 2-gen community work where we're assisting the youth in connecting with skills and being prepared for college. And I want all the high school principals to consider contacting us to learn more about that program.
That sounds like an interesting program. Well, how can somebody get involved with you who happens to be watching who maybe isn't in high school?
So visit us at connectionstosuccess.org. Send me an email at n@napoleonwilliams@connectionstosuccess.org or call one of our offices, 314-584-6702 or 636-8027.
And why did Connections to Success want to get involved with the Bommarito High School Prep Zone Game of the Week?
Football is a great way to teach children about commitment, hard work, determination, teamwork. We had to be involved with something like that, and we're extremely excited. And plus, I'm a big football fan, so it makes sense.
That always helps. Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
All right, thank you, Angela. Got her through the hole at the 40, at the 50, still going at the opposite 40, 30, 20, 10, and down at the 4-yard line. Reese Goddard with an explosive run and gain for Kirkwood and the touchdown saving tackle by Andrew Jones.
And this is the reason why you keep pounding away with the run. The running game is going to win this game today. Here's the misdirection, fake it there to hold the defensive end, and then right up the middle. Now you see the speed and the athletic ability right up the middle. Great job by Andrew Jones, the defensive back, the senior defensive back of Parkway North, running him down from behind because that was a touchdown. Very well-executed play. It started off with the offensive line. And the offensive line, whoever wins this game, is going to be about the offensive line.
First and goal for the Pioneers, trying to strike first in this game here in the second quarter. Bad snap. Inside handoff, going to lose yardage, and that might.
He was on a knee, I think.
I think you're right. I think Goddard caught it on a knee.
Absolutely.
And they're just going to call him down right there back at about the 7 or 8 yard line.
That's a good catch by the referee because when Goddard caught that ball, he was already on a knee. And that means he's down.
High school football, college football, you're down. Even without contact, you are down. And that was a little pop fly snap. I don't know if it hit somebody on the way up or, again, you know, wet conditions. The center lost it on the way up. Second and goal back at the 8. Goddard will keep it himself. Tries to get outside. Cut back inside. Hard running. And touchdown, Reese Goddard. And the Kirkwood Pioneers. And they strike first. And Kirkwood leads it 6-0.
That's what they want to do. Pound away with the run. They have a very athletic, big, strong running back or a quarterback who acts like a running back when he puts that ball away. He runs like one. Here you go off to the left. Fakes it to the right to hold the DN. The guard and tackle pull out front. There's a great job blocking there by number 59, exploding right through his man. And that was Gavin DeBoer, the offensive lineman, pulling over and opening a big hole for the touchdown.
Missed the extra point. The score remains 6-0 with 5:19 to go in the opening quarter. You know, Reese Goddard played a lot as a sophomore, and he was their running quarterback. He almost never passed the ball as a sophomore. They'd put him in various situations, and he would just run. And we know he has that ability. Ran for 900-plus yards last year and really hasn't been running a lot yet this year, but good look there at Reese Goddard.
It was a place like Harris Stowe that took a chance on me as a first-generation college student from a single-parent household. A place like Harris Stowe provided me an educational opportunity that allowed me to be the youngest college president in the country. Harris Stowe has amazing degree programs. We have one of the most quality, affordable educations in this region. Small classroom environment, family environment, very welcoming to all students, and be prepared to be a global leader in a global society. Harris Stowe is the place for you.
For more than a century, the St. Louis Carpenters Union has shaped St. Louis. Through trusted alliances, we deliver skilled professional craftspeople, while our business partners provide the kind of quality jobs that keep our economy humming. It's a blueprint that has worked since 1882. A career in union carpentry means great pay, exceptional benefits, and professional skills training unmatched in the industry. We are 20,000 members strong, and we work for St. Louis. Visit carpdc.org to learn more.
Nick Williams, a 6 foot 180 junior, missed that extra point. And now he's ready to kick it off, and it continues to rain and pour here at Kirkwood. The big factor, though, no lightning there and thunder. That's the big deal. Williams, high end over end kick. This is Butler, fumbles it, and then picks it up at the 10. They're setting up a reverse, and they fumble that. And out to about the 18-yard line. Boy, once you kick it, don't you just give up the ghost and run up the field?
Yeah, but when you already have a reverse called, it's hard to call off that reverse in mid-play. As you see, actually like the play call here with the reverse to try to catch him off guard. But Kirkwood was very disciplined standing in the lane. But once you drop the ball, now all the blocking and timing is off, and it throws off a trick play like that.
Parkway North had great field position their first three possessions. Now the last two, they've ended up in their own zone. Kirkwood leads it now for the first time tonight, 6-0. As you can see there, 5:18 left in the opening half. On the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week, Hertzler yet to complete a pass. And the handoff, trying to get outside, losing yardage. And well, we talked about Wiley. Clearly, they didn't throw him out of the game. He just made the tackle. So we now know the rule.
Right. And Parkway North has really squandered some great opportunities in that first quarter because they were really getting the ball at the 50-yard line and plus territory, and they couldn't move the ball. Now they look up and find themselves behind here, and they're deep in their own zone. They've struggled passing the ball. They're going to have to try to get this running game going. This big offensive line is where you want to start, and they just haven't been able to move Kirkwood.
Out of the eye and three wide receivers and the inside handoff trying to take it outside is Suber. And he'll get positive yardage across the 15 out near the 16, 17, maybe a pickup of three for Suber. And, you know, you're a fan, you're looking, man, that's so conservative. But in this weather, it is extremely difficult to get the passing game going.
Watch number 7, Telfair, on the left side DN. Watch him get up the field right here, and that forces the runner back in. That's all that he did his job. That's all he wanted to do. Now, he does come back and make the tackle as well because he's such a great athlete. But as a DN, you just want to get up the field and force the running back to cut back inside. And if he does, which he did, you should have plenty of help coming.
3rd and 7 through the hole and a gain, but short of the first down. And Parkway North will be punting again.
Yeah, Parkway North finds themselves in a situation that they haven't been in all year. Usually, right around halftime, they're up by a score or two. Defensively, they're playing well, so that's where they're going to hang their hat. But they're going to have to put up some points in this game. They're going to have to find a running game. I think the passing game today is going to be mute for both teams. They're going to have to find another way to score, whether by special teams, a turnover, or getting that running game going.
Farron hangs this one high. It'll hit at the 40. Oh, and take a great Parkway North bounce inside the 30 and near the 25-yard line. Our thanks to Fisher's Pro Line Sports, outfitting your team from head to toe and a strong supporter of high school sports. I stand corrected, by the way, Phillips' first pick of the year. He's had two in each of the last 2 years. And now Goddard wants long distance, and he has a man. It's near the 20-yard line. He connects with Taj Telfair. Wow, that was a terrific pass.
Absolutely. Good job of putting that ball up. Andrew Jones, the corner, the senior corner, is right there to make the play. It looks like he hesitated just a bit, and the ball just drops right on the chest. Great throw, great execution, and when you're throwing a ball that long, that far, it starts with that offensive line and making sure they're giving the quarterback time. They gave Goddard time. He was able to put that ball right on the money.
Right at a 40-yard gain for Kirkwood and their outstanding wide receiver and quarterback, Taj Telfair. Goddard back to pass again, going to get hit. He is sacked back at the 28-yard line. There's a flag on the far sideline. And it continues to rain in our booth. I keep sliding further and further back away from the window. We await the signal. The play was a sack of Reese Goddard. If it stands, it'll be the third sack. And the Parkway folks are saying, we don't want the penalty. So apparently it was on the Pioneers. another false start that will be declined. Third sack of the night.
If it's false start, they usually blow the play dead and stop it right there. For some reason, they let the play continue. And because of that, Goddard took a hit. I know he's looking like, wait a minute, if it's false start, please blow the play dead so I don't have to take this hit.
And now we're ready to go. Second and 16, and they wind the clock. Goddard wants points, flips to the right side, and just a little too far for the intended receiver, Tyreek Lewis. It'll go incomplete, and Goddard is unofficially 6 of 10. Watch it here.
This is a very good play design as Tyreek Lewis comes out of the backfield uncovered. Goddard just wants to put it on his chest and just lays it out far, just a little bit too far. Blown coverage, as you see, both corners are going with that receiver at the top of the field. One of those corners has to get the back out, so they got lucky there, Parkway North did, because that was a blown coverage. Goddard saw it, just didn't get the ball to the back.
Third and 16, late in the half. Pitch it for the left side. He wants Telfair again, and that one is almost intercepted. Safety coming over to help out and knocking it down. And a good effort, and Jason Hawkins almost came up with the pick, and it's fourth down.
That's a good job by the junior safety, reading the eyes of Goddard. This ball hangs in the air just a little bit too long, and then the safety has a beat on it right there. Has it right in his hands. Couldn't squeeze it, couldn't hold it. Missed opportunity there by North to get the ball back right before half.
Kirkwood goes for it on fourth down. Goddard rolls right, has room, looks, guns for the end zone, and it is incomplete. Through the hands of Phillips, couldn't pull it down, and he might have been out of bounds had he caught it. And so Parkway North will take over with 21 seconds. No points allowed there, and that's important for Parkway North in this soggy field. Any points could be a problem.
Absolutely. And I love the play call. Go for it on fourth down. It's right before the half. You roll the quarterback out, so you give him a pass run option, and he just led the receiver just a little bit too much. He's got to have to understand that if he throws that ball more on a line, even if it's picked off, it's okay. It'll just be returned, or it'll just be, you know, touchback, and they just get the ball at the 20-yard line. He tried to get a little bit, put a little bit too much touch on it, and it was just a little bit too much, and it was overthrown.
Now, if I'm Parkway North, I think I'm
sitting on the ball.
Yeah, I don't want to make a mistake at this end, and that looks like they're kind of in victory formation.
Best formation in football.
They'll take a knee. That will wrap up the first half. A halftime score, 6-0. Kirkwood out in front of Parkway North in the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week.
Doesn't it seem like the wireless world today could use a smile? At Cricket Wireless, we think so.
2-year contract?
That's why with us, you don't have to worry about annual contracts. Prices for our plans are all in, taxes and fees included. And we've got more 4G LTE coverage nationwide than T-Mobile or Sprint. That's a whole lot of network for not a lot of dough. It's what makes Cricket the happiest place in the whole wireless world. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
Precision, consistency, accuracy. That's Dead On Sports.
And welcome back to Kirkwood High School, the home of the Pioneers. They're hosting the Parkway North Vikings on the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week. Isaac Bird's here. I'm Harry Schrader. 6-0. Kirkwood out in front here at the halftime. Both teams back on the field starting to do their stretching. And it was a soggy first half. And I will show you some of the numbers. They're reflected there. 47 rushing yards for Parkway North. None in the passing game. 109 rushing yards for Kirkwood. 70 of those on one run by the quarterback, Reese Goddard. 66 passing yards. 40 of those on one play. You take away two plays and there's almost nothing to say about the offense for either side. No first downs for Parkway North in the first half.
Wow.
Five or six, maybe. I think it's five on the first down for Kirkwood. And we'll show you the touchdown. Reese Goddard pounding it in from about four or five, maybe about 8 yards out, I guess it was. Well, this is the play that set it up. He's going to run 70 yards down to about the four-yard line, a big gap there. You can see good blocking, and then he just took off down the sideline. Touchdown saving tackle there. And about two plays later, Goddard was able to power it in from about the 8 yard line. You'll see it here. Good blocking up front.
Good job with the guard and tackle. Pulled it from right to left. 59, 66 right there. Get that blocked, and it gets skinny and gets that ball right over the end zone. Great job.
Goddard gets the rushing touchdown. To show it to you again from a little bit of a different angle. Misdirection, pulling lineman. And they made no mistake on the blocks. And Goddard can, for a quarterback, he can lower the shoulder and deliver.
And Goddard did a good job there setting up the blocking as he was going outside. And what that does is that held the defenders outside. And he waited for his lineman to get in on the inside, make the block. Then he came through for the touchdown. So that was a great execution all over the board.
Pioneers trying to get loose, get those quads loose and those groins loose. 1:14 away from the kickoff. Kirkwood won the opening coin toss, the Lions Choice coin toss, and they elected to defer. So they lead by six, and they'll have the football to start this second half. And neither team obviously able to do a lot offensively, Isaac. So what is the mindset going into this third quarter?
Well, if you're Kirkwood, you're right where you want to be. You're going to receive the ball. You run the ball here. It almost seems as though that if you're able to put another 6 points on the board and go up by two scores, that may actually be enough because of the weather.
Elements, right?
Absolutely. So you want to run the ball. You want to try to take the air out the ball, shorten the game, shorten the time of possession that Parkway North's going to have. But in order to do that, you got to convert third downs.
Let's send it down to our talented sideline reporter, Angela Sharp.
Hey there, I'm Matt Bierman from the Elite Football Academy with me. Glad to have you back. Are there some guys out here you guys train?
Yeah, you know what? It's a nice and wet game out here, but we've got both quarterbacks from the team. Reese Goddard here is having a good night, really big run. Luke Hertzler from Parkway North. Big Michael Thompson, who's one of the premier defensive linemen in the country. He's got offers at pretty much every major school and still got another year to play. So these guys are out here. Kind of one of those hallmark or trademark games, I guess, that you'll remember your whole adult life, getting it to play out here in a nice, rainy, wet night, and they'll have a nice TV telecast to remember it by, right?
To remember it by. You got to love that. Yeah. Did you work with them a little bit on how to deal with rain, those quarterbacks?
Yeah, do different drills with, just making them uncertain about different elements. You can't really replicate this, but there's certain things you can do to the ball or just, it's more about mindset, though, getting these guys to understand to focus on their job and be trained to do exactly what their coaches need them to do.
Yeah, you need that. And you guys start really early, too.
Yeah, we just got done every Friday night. We get to do our flag football right before we come out and watch the big boys play. But we have young kids, 5 years old up through middle schoolers, starting to learn the game of football the right way, learning fundamentals all the way up to a point to where they can get out here and start to play at a high level in high school.
And how can somebody get their child involved in Elite Football Academy?
The easiest way is to log on to our site, elitefootball.net. From there, you can do a free session of one of our skills development classes, also our speed and agility class. Come in and try it out. Learn to become a complete athlete and understand what it takes to really meet the goals that you're trying to achieve, whether that's just learning the game, whether that's trying to start, whether that's trying to go on to be a collegiate or a professional athlete.
So any level, even if you just want to learn the rules.
Yeah, just learn the rules. Whatever it might be, just come on out and we'll get you taken care of.
We I love that. Definitely check out the Elite Football Academy. Why did you choose to be a part of the Bommarito High School Prep Zone Game of the Week?
Quite honestly, it's one of the easiest ways to give back and let these guys experience something that's going to be with them for a long time. So anytime we can support the guys that we get to train in the community we're in, we love that opportunity. And this is really a great opportunity that you guys are creating for these kids, and we couldn't, you know, be any more proud to be a part of it.
Yeah, and we love to be here. Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
All right, thank you, Angela. Quick pitch to Newton. He's across the 40, 45 into the Kirkwood territory at the Kirkwood 45, and a quick hitter in the first completion of the night for Hertzler. Newton's going to get up slow. His knee kind of buckled on that tackle, and he's limping to the sideline.
Yes, and then when you want to try to complete passes in this weather, you want to do short passes there. Travion Mosby comes up. He's in position to make the play, misses the tackle, and leads to a big run. Travion had a very good first half. He played a very good safety, came up, made a couple of tackles, comes in. That's his man. He misses the tackle there, but look out for him. That's why you don't want to throw the ball deep, because Travion Mosby is one of those guys that can pick one off and you try to throw it too deep for him.
Sweeping right, big hole inside the 40, flag behind the play. One of the better runs of the night for Parkway North, but that's going to be a hold against the Vikings. And we'll try to keep an eye on that Parkway North sideline as their terrific tight end and linebacker Ryan Newton went down with a jankety knee.
And when you throw it, you really want to focus on the quick passing game. So I'll be surprised if Kirkwood doesn't bring their corners up and try to play press coverage to make those throwing lanes disappear. Because when you're in zone, when you're throwing the ball quick, it's very easy to get the ball out and make those completions. If you miss one tackle, as we just saw there, it can lead to a long catch and run.
What a devastating play there. The hold was behind the line of scrimmage. Instead of being second and about five, it's going to be first and 20-plus yards. So they drop all the way back to their own 40, 41-yard line. Do the Vikings of Parkway North run it again? And a big hole across the 45 out to about the 47-yard line. Pickup of about six for Keon Butler.
And once again, coming from his safety position, Travion Mosby, the junior transfer, comes in, gets low, and that's a good tackle. Gets his head across the knees and makes sure he brings that tackler down. That's what you want to do as a safety. You want to come flat downhill, and you know if you miss that tackle, it's going to be a long run, but he's so confident, he comes right in and makes the tackle. Very good play.
Take it one way, go the other way. A little bit of a gap on the wing now to the midfield. Stripe to 45, still going and going to get to about the 42-yard line where he's gang tackled, and that's a nice little run. It's going to be third down and about eight, pickup of about 10 for Mr. Suber.
This is one of the ways you can slow down a very fast and aggressive defense. You just go misdirection. Here's the pulling guard and tackle, comes up from the left side, pulled into the right, then he gets outside. Good job putting his foot in the ground and getting right up the field. Look at him fighting for those little extra yards, which is very important in a very close game like this.
Third and about seven, maybe 8 yards to go, and a different quarterback. It's Jelani Williams, typically a defensive back. They were going with a bit of a wildcat look there, and he got back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all.
Yeah, that play just took too long. Telfair saw it the entire time, and he runs it down from behind, get those hands on him, and then this is a very good stop by Kirkwood. The last thing they wanted to do was to come out and give up a tying touchdown. Good job getting off the field on third down.
And here's a snap. Somebody jumped, obviously. It'll go against Parkway North. And that doesn't really bother them at that particular place. Farron's going to plant it down around the 10-yard line anyway.
And sometimes it actually helps you get a little bit more room as a punter. You want those little extra 5 yards, just give you a little bit more room to drop that ball inside the 10.
This one's high, and Jordan steps up to catch it at about the 10, bobbles it, and fell on it right there at the 10-yard line, and a dangerous play for the Kirkwood Pioneers. But they survived, and they will hold on to the football right at their own 10. You watch it there, the replay sponsored by the American Jeep Fitters.
Jordan has to understand here, look, there's nowhere to go here. There's three runners, three defenders right in front of you. Call fair catch, catch the ball, and let your offense take it from there.
So deep in their own territory are the Kirkwood Pioneers with that 6-love lead. Got to be careful here in the wet conditions. Try not to make this offensive set something that's good for the offensive production of Parkway North. Goddard in the gun, misdirection, good handoff the other way out across the 10, maybe the 12-yard line. Clay with the carry.
That is a really, really good play by Greg Wright. The linebacker coming in from the left side. He's on the edge. It's a run blitz, and they're just guessing they're going to run. He comes right off the edge, gets low, wraps him up, and now he forces second and long. That's just a very good call by the defensive coordinator with a run blitz from the outside, and then the defender coming in making a play.
Goddard looking, throws long, and there's no receiver there, and it's intercepted at the 40. Turning it back up the field. It's Jones. He'll give ground to the 50, now takes it forward to the 40, breaking tackles and down to the 35-yard line. Andrew Jones, we saw him make a touchdown-saving tackle earlier, and now he ran down the pass and picked it off.
Yeah, it's one of the plays that Parkway North needed to try to get some energy back into this to this offense. It looks like the receiver just stopped. He was confused on the route.
I didn't think Jones could get to it, but he ran it down and the big turnover, and now Parkway North with an opportunity to tie this football game.
That is a very difficult catch by Jones. That ball is coming right over his head. He's looking up almost behind him. Water is coming down right in his eyes. His concentration level had to be extremely high. He knew how important that ball was. He caught it, and now gives North the ball here on the plus 50.
And on first down, Hertzler is buried back at the 32-yard line on the blitz coming from the outside, and that was Tyndall, Armand Tyndall, coming off the edge. Let's watch the replay of the interception.
As he's covering his man, he sees the ball. Now look at his eyes. This ball is fading right over the shoulder, so now he has to be a receiver here. With no gloves, gets up and catches that ball. That is a tremendous, difficult catch, even for a receiver to make, let alone a defensive back.
Loss of about 6 on the sack. And nowhere to go on this sweep. Too many red jerseys. They continue to play terrific defense. Barnett was there. So was Moore.
Also, Orvell Ferguson, a DN, 6'4", 200 pounds. He did a really good job getting up the field. This Kirkwood defense has played exceptional tonight.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I know the weather can equalize and slow down a very good offense. And it, you know, so you I'm sure they got some help with there too. But you still got to play the game. This defense has gotten off the field on third down. Now it's 3rd and 18.
Hertzler under pressure, throws over the middle, and it's caught. Jones has it at the 30 and brought down right there. A nice pickup. It'll set up 4th and just a couple of yards to go. And you wonder if they bring Farron out for the bomb field goal or they just go for it here. Probably 4-down territory.
Yeah, I think you have to go for it here because you want to try to tie this game. Now you're down at around the 30-yard line. And if you don't go for it, okay, you give it to them there at the 30. But it's 4th and 4. This is extremely important, and you maybe even call in for the offense as a no play. Say,
and
listen,
now,
there's
now Bob
no play.
Bunn just called a timeout. They were a little bit confused. He'll call the timeout, and so they will talk over what they want to do in this next situation. Tonight's telecast brought to you in part by Noodles & Company. Real food, real cooking, real flavors. They have locations all over the St. Louis metropolitan area. We had noodles for supper tonight. Terrific food from our friends at Noodles and Company. Jones, by the way, makes the catch on this offensive set. He made the interception to set it up. The interception was his 3rd of the year. The catch was his 4th of the year. And he's been a very valuable guy tonight for Bob Bunton.
And it helps him being a receiver, playing offense, being a receiver, because to catch that ball over your head that way, you actually have to put yourself in the mind of a receiver, because that ball is coming straight over the top. He's fading away. That's a doubly tough catch for anyone to make. And in a tight game like this, it's plays like that that the offense needs to kind of get going. So now he's put his team in a situation to where it's fourth and four. They're going to bring the offense back out, which I agree, and go for it.
And you wonder if they took that time out. They're starting tight end out with a little bit of a knee injury. You wonder if even the package, they got out there and said, well, wait, we're missing somebody, or the wrong guy is in the wrong spot. So they go three wide to the bottom of your screen, single wide receiver to the top. Good look at the quarterback there, Hertzler, in the gun on a big fourth down play. Back to pass, has time, hit, and it's almost intercepted. It'll go incomplete. And Parkway North fails to convert in a big stand by that Kirkwood defense.
Once again, that Kirkwood defense is all over the place. And I believe that was number 52, Yvonne Burnett, that gets in there and deflects this ball. But watch the defensive line. Great job getting low and then getting through there and affecting that pass. Great job by Luke Moore, the D lineman, the 6'1", 185-pound D lineman, gets low, gets free, then comes in and deflects that pass. And that gives the ball right back to Kirkwood. And you would think Kirkwood would try to use some clock here and run the football.
Out of the gun, the Pioneers. And the misdirection. Going back the other way across the 30, 35. Good run out to about the 42-yard line. Nicely done by Mr. Clay. Let's send it down to Angela Sharp on the sideline.
I've got Luke from Dead On Sports with me here today. Now, somebody who knows nothing about Dead On Sports, what do you do?
So basically, we build a quarterback and long snapper target that you can use, you know, to build accuracy. Because that's what we do. We build accuracy. And when we set out, we set out to build something that was kind of simple, but you know, easy to see and to give you better points of contact when you throw the football and you hit it. You actually see where you're throwing, so you can make the adjustments to become dead on, rather than just throwing at a target for the sake of throwing at a target.
Now, these are in patterns and colors, and why is that?
Yeah, absolutely. So we use a certain pattern and colors, so no matter where you're at on the football field, you can see it. You know, like I said before, you're not just throwing at a target just to throw at a target. You're throwing at something that you can see, whether you're 30 yards away, 10 yards away, 50 yards away. You can see it. You can recognize what you're hitting and, you know, make the adjustments when you're not hitting what you need to hit to be able to become, once again, dead on.
And do you see people's accuracy improve with this?
Absolutely. I mean, we have guys working out at Elite Football Academy, which, you know, we test everything that we do out there. So they use our products week in and week out. And actually, the two quarterbacks today have used our products, and I think it's actually showing off pretty well in the rain. I mean, I've seen some pretty accurate passes for, you know, the weather we're having. So I would say yes, absolutely.
Absolutely. Well, how can somebody find your product?
So you can find us in your regular Sporting Good catalog or through Shutt Sports, Kurt Smith's in Belleville, Illinois, and MVP in Camdenton, Missouri.
Awesome. Definitely check out Dead End Sports. Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
All right. Thank you, Angela. After a nice run by Clay, there was a holding penalty against Kirkwood, going to wipe away the first down. We'll march them back to about the 35-yard line, and I've watched people use those dead-on sports targets, and they really do help the players. So second and long for Kirkwood now after a devastating penalty against the Pioneers. Empty backfield this time, and Goddard on the quarterback sweep. And he'll run out of bounds and get a couple.
Goddard has to understand the situation here. They don't call this play to get you out of bounds to stop the clock. You definitely want to get around the edge. But, you know, right before you go out of bounds here, this is a design run to the left. Good block by his backer here. Now put your foot in the ground right here and then get up the field, even if that means taking on number 22 to get a couple of yards. That's what you have to do in that situation. Time is of the essence here if you're Kirkwood, and possessions. You don't want to give North the ball any more than you have to. Now you're in third and long.
Third and 13 out of the gun. Goddard will roll right. Look down the field. Look. And now he'll take off and run and lose yardage. Maybe just a yard, but it'll be fourth down, and didn't like what he saw down the field and probably made a wise choice that time.
Yeah, sometimes you have to eat it. And sometimes the defense wins. You know, they had a sprint out to the right. They had a couple of flat routes to the right side for a couple of receivers. They were well covered. What he didn't want to do is throw it out of bounds to stop the clock. So he did a good job of putting the ball down, and that means taking a hit. So be it, but you keep the clock rolling. Your defense is playing very well tonight. You kick the ball, and you have your defense go out there and tell them to stop them again.
Barnett to punt it again. McMiller deep for Parkway North. In a 6-0 game, the Pioneers out in front. And Barnett gets away. Boy, they were coming hard. McMiller retreats to the 25. Comes up the near side 30 and gets down at about the 31-yard line. Good coverage by the Kirkwood Pioneers in on the tackle. Number 31, R.J. Jackson.
I was sick of working dead-end jobs. I wanted to have a career. Battle-Eye gave me the hands-on experience to build my future. Them teachers were very good.
The purpose of them coming to Battle-Rot is to learn a trade. As an instructor, I'm gonna be there for them.
They just made me feel like a brand new person.
He's been working with me for some years, and I'm proud of him and the things that they have instilled in him.
I wanted to follow my dad's footsteps, but now I figured out through Battle-Rot, I could be better than my dad. Battle-Rot had really changed my life.
The receiver, Jelani Williams, went out grabbing his hamstring. Inside handoff, and Suber has nowhere to go. Maybe lost a yard, and it'll be fourth down. And Parkway North's offense has been stuck in neutral most of the night.
Absolutely. Those linebackers are all over the place. Watch number four, Tyreek Lewis, the linebacker. He reads it and gets up under the block right there, sheds the block, and then makes the tackle. That is textbook by a linebacker. Take on the offensive lineman, shed the blocker, then come down and make the tackle.
Low snap, but Farron gets it off. It will land at the 25, go inside the 20, and all the way down near the 10-yard line. Great bounce and a nice punt again by Jack Farron.
Yeah, I know Joe Jordan, the returner there, wanted to pick that ball up. He gave him maybe 20 yards there, but it's so tricky. That ball takes a bad hop and hits your chest, and it's free and live. Now North jumps on the ball and have an opportunity to score. So it's a good play. I know he gave up 15 yards there letting that ball bounce, but in this weather and with that defense, how well the defense is playing, go ahead, let it drop, let it roll back, and hope that your offense can convert at least a couple of first downs before having to punt the ball.
Pioneers with that 6-0 lead. This game is going quickly by because of a lack of scoring and thus stoppages of the clock. And the Pioneers have it deep in their own end. Inside handoff and just a couple of yards, not even a couple, maybe 1 yard, lunging forward, Tyreek Lewis.
Zach Scott coming from his linebacker position, 6'1", 210 senior. Good job of reading that running play, getting inside and holding them up. Once you wrap them up, you want to hold them up and let your friends come and try to strip that ball away. That's exactly what Scott did there. Great job there on first down.
Two gritty defenses playing well tonight in the rain. The offense is struggling a bit. Quick pass left side, complete. Nope, drop. Jordan couldn't hold on to it. And it'll be third down and 9.
I like the fact they want to try to complete something short here. The ball is right here. It's right on him. Good throw. He has to make this catch. This has to be a catch here. Even if Jordan only picks up 3-4 yards there, that's fine. There's no problem. Now you get the ball back on third down. It makes it 3rd and 4, which is more manageable than 3rd and 9. So that's a big drop at this time in the game.
3rd and 9. Goddard went for a hard count there, hoping to pull the Vikings off. That didn't work. Now he looks to the sideline, gets the rest of the play. And he's back to pass on 3rd down. Slant is batted down at the line of scrimmage. It might have been Scott that knocked it down. They're all congratulating him. I think it was Zach Scott. Check that, Zach Kern. Had my wrong Zach there. And it'll be 4th down, and Kirkwood will be punting from very deep in their own zone. And Parkway North had pretty good field position most of the night. just haven't been able to do much with it.
And that's the problem on second down. When you drop that ball on second down, it brings up third and long, and it stops the clock. So Kirkwood gets the ball, and they don't even take more than 30 seconds off the clock before they have to give it right back to Parkway North.
Boy, what a punt. Great punt. A line drive that goes over the head of McMiller, has to retreat to the 25-yard line, and he'll get it across the 30 to the 35. But by rifling it over the head of the returner, that was a brilliant play by Ivan Barnett.
Absolutely. Exactly what they needed was a big punt there, and that's exactly what they got. Vashon Emerson comes down and make the tackle there. So an excellent, excellent punt.
Watch this. Now, a 40-yard punt would have landed at the 50-yard line. It lands at the 30, the opposite, 35, and then takes a good bounce. What a terrific play. So we check the field, and once again, I do not see. A little bit of a different setup, a little bit of a wing formation.
Absolutely.
Near side, Suber hurdles a man and across the 40 to the 44. He's been their most effective back tonight, Suber, who's very active in their offense, but not the starter. He's been their best running player tonight.
And if you're Parkway North, you're just trying to find something that works. If you're Coach Button, you're just trying to find a combination of backs that's going to give you that spark. And maybe they found one right now, because that's what you're looking for. You need somebody to give you that spark offensively, because it has not been there all day.
Same formation, but to the opposite side. And the same play, sweeping left. Suber, 45, first down, knocked out of bounds near the midfield stripe. And a couple of players get into it a little bit, conversation out near the 45-yard line, but Suber gets first down. And they have found something that they think will work, and it's worked on the first two plays. But I see the Parkway North players walking backwards. I don't see a flag. And, yeah, there's no reason for them to walk backwards. It is a first down out near the midfield stripe.
Well, they definitely found a little bit of something here of trying to get outside this Kirkwood defense. I guess they're believing that they're tiring him down with that offensive line.
Well, they set up that wing, that fullback on the wing, and he's been able to make some nice blocks on the edge there. Into the hole, through the hole, inside the 45. Best drive of the night, really. For the Parkway North Vikings, you can hear the siren. Suber gets positive yardage, and the third quarter is over. Kirkwood leads it 6-0. Parkway North is driving on the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week.
When Chris graduates with his liberal arts degree, his starting salary is $25,000. That's if he can find a job. When Steve graduates from MTC Truck Driving School, he'll work for a national company at $50,000 a year. Which route would you take? Hop on at beatrucker.com.
Let's send it down to Angela Sharp.
I have our Lions Choice Family of the Game. Now, I mentioned earlier, since a lot of people left because of the rain, the Family of the Game tonight was going to be very special. I've got the young family here. Who are your children out here?
Cornell Young is number 3, Travion Mosby is number 14, and David Young is number 25, set of twins and an extra baby.
There you go. So you are cheering on all three of them this evening.
All three of them, and then the rest of the Kirkwood family as well.
That's right. You have been very loud yourself. I hear you yelling and screaming out here. Do you like watching your kids play?
Absolutely. They look forward to me hollering. They always say when they get home, "I didn't hear you yell, Mother," so they lose games when I'm not here.
So you need to yell. Now, is this a future player right here?
This is. This is Sugar Wooga. Say hi, Sugar Wooga.
Well, you guys are our Lions Choice Family of the Game. Lions Choice, serving real roast beef since 67. I have a $50 gift card. You can go take all those kids out and get some cones and roast beef.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
I'm going to start calling Isaac Sugar Wooga, I think. That's a name.
Let's not.
Second and 11, Lewis into the pile for about four. fullback dive there kind of caught them off balance, and a nice run by Tariq Lewis.
I love the smash mouth right at you, right down the line.
Check that, Ryan Smith. I just want to correct myself.
Right down the line, smash mouth right at you. And that's what Parkway North is wanting to do right now. They've got to get something going, and it's almost a sense of urgency right now with this offense. They're right around the 30-yard line. They know we've got to get this ball in the end zone. You're definitely looking at four downs here. So you have four downs to get 10, and you have to get the ball in the end zone right now if you're Parkway North.
Hertzler to Super, and he'll fall forward for maybe a couple. You know, we have not seen Ryan Newton check back in the game since he went down with that tweaked knee, and that is a bigger deal than just what goes on in this game as we watch the replay. Ryan Newton is really the backbone of this team, and if he's out any extended period of time, that's going to really hurt this Viking squad.
Good job right there by Tyree Wiley coming in, shedding the blocker, and then wrapping up that runner. He's been having a good game all night as well. I tell you what, this Kirkwood defense, everyone from the defensive line all the way back to the secondary has really had a really good game tonight.
Parkway North takes the timeout. They were a bit confused. And again, I wonder if you've got some of the guys, your staples that are not playing, I wonder if sometimes that you get the wrong guy out there or the package doesn't seem right, so you have to call a timeout to fix it.
Yeah, and on fourth down, this is the time right now is too important to not make sure that everyone is on the same page. This is a very big play. I like the timeout because you may not get down here again. So you call a timeout and make sure everyone's on the same page. You may even want to go on, say, a hard count here and just tell your lineman, please do not jump here. We're going on hard count to see if we can pick up that first down by one of those guys jumping offside. And if not, we're going to run this particular play. So I like the first down to really make sure everyone's on the same page.
You don't often think 9:39 left in a game is a critical time period, but in a wet, soggy field where the offenses have not been able to move, this could be a critical play in the game.
Absolutely. Because, again, you may not get down here again. So whatever the play you're most comfortable with as a team, whatever that best play is, we're going to see it from Parkway North tonight right now.
I wanted to see the fullback on the wing again, but they didn't do it, and Hertzler is going to throw. Little swing pass, has the man in the flat, and I think a first down. We'll see where they mark it. He was right at the stick. Little swing pass out to the running back, Smith. And we'll see where they mark it. It is very close.
That is a great job by Smith, knowing his number was called and them saying, you must get this first down. When he caught the ball, he was 6 yards short. And when he was first contacted, he was about 3 yards short. And then he really fought for those extra 3 yards.
Well, they are really scrutinizing it. The Parkway North people seem to be disappointed with the spot. You can see the official standing there. I think they're going to call it a fourth. I think they're going to give the ball to Kirkwood. Let's see if we can see it on the replay. The officials are going to measure now.
It looks short from.
Let's watch Ryan Smith catch this ball out of the backfield.
This is a design play. Fullback pretend he's blocking, then go out into
the
flat.
He's got to get to the 24.
Lewis misses the tackle there. And then
He looks like he made it to me.
The question is, was his right leg,
sure,
right foot out of bounds? And with the angle we have, we really couldn't tell if that right foot was out of bounds or not.
I think the officials are saying first down for somebody, but I think they're going to move the sticks.
First down, Parkway North. That offense is on the field.
Wow. That was death-defying for both teams waiting for that to be sorted out.
Kirkwood's defense has been strong all night. They got to once again come up with a very strong performance on this possession to get the ball back.
On first down, it's Super again. He's going to get to the edge, inside the 20, inside the 15, down near the 12, and another first down for Parkway North. But what a gutsy call by Bob Bunton's offense. They haven't passed the ball well at all, and they went to the pass on that critical fourth down play.
Not only the pass, but to a player who's not used to catching the football. You go to a pass and you use the fullback on a slip block out in the flat, and then he catches it and just use that big body of his to get the first down. Then you come right back on your next play with another first down run. So now this offensive Parkway North is starting to move.
Down to the 13-yard line, trying to get that tying score, and hopefully the extra point for the leading scorer. Suber, not much room that time. He has been the workhorse here in the second half.
Yeah, and once again, a very good job by Tariq Lewis for Kirkwood.
Good news for Parkway North. Jelani Williams, we saw him go out grabbing his hamstring, but he's out there playing right now. So that's good news for Parkway North on the injury front. As we mentioned, we still haven't seen Ryan Newton since he went out with that what looked to be a knee injury. Pickup of one for Suber on first down, second and nine. Give it to him again. Stutter step, good pursuit by Kirkwood. Number of guys there, but one of them, Armon Tindall, coming in from his linebacker position. Good look at him there, number six.
Absolutely. The junior linebacker comes in. I like how he stayed low. You don't want to try to tackle high. Watch when he comes in here. He's free. Now get low, get real low, and then just wrap him up and wait for your friends to come. Good job getting in there and getting down. Not trying to do too much. Don't try to, you know, try to strip the ball and miss the tackle. Just wrap your arms around them. Make sure you bring them down to the ground.
Big third down play here. Third and nine. Hertzler back under pressure. Throws the slant, and it's incomplete. And it'll be fourth down. Pressure was coming. Got it off quickly, but too far out in front of the attendant receiver.
Well, Andrew Jones has to run that route
to win. He didn't
complete
the route, did he?
Absolutely. He stopped. He saw the corner coming down or the safety coming down, and instead of crossing his face, watch him stop and cut off his route. You can't do that. Even though he sees that.
I think that pass was blocked, too.
Was it?
I think it was tipped at the line, too. But, yeah, he just kind of gave up on the route momentarily.
Absolutely.
There.
Big fourth down here for Kirkwood now.
Obviously
Kirkwood's
not
defense.
Trying to kick the field goal here. That does them no good. 7:56 to go. Fourth and nine. Can they convert again? Lobbing it up and incomplete. The ball was well short. Hertzler couldn't get it off, and it was wobbly all the way. And another stop
slipped.
By Kirkwood.
It was a place like Harrisville that took a chance on me as a first-generation college student from a single-parent household. A place like Harrisville provided me an educational opportunity that allowed me to be the youngest college president in the country. Harrisville has amazing degree programs. We have one of the most quality, affordable educations in this region. Small classroom environment, family environment, very welcoming to all students, and be prepared to be a global leader in a global society. Harrisville is the place for you.
For more than a century, the St. Louis Carpenters Union has shaped St. Louis. Through trusted alliances, we deliver skilled professional craftspeople, while our business partners provide the kind of quality jobs that keep our economy humming. It's a blueprint that has worked since 1882. A career in union carpentry means great pay, exceptional benefits, and professional skills training unmatched in the industry. We are 20,000 members strong, and we work for St. Louis. Visit carpdc.org to learn more.
Goddard on the misdirection and breaking a tackle out near the 30, 31, still going out to about the 34-yard line, and that was all about effort by Tariq Lewis. Lewis was hit in the backfield, spun out of one tackle, you'll see it here, and then just wouldn't go down.
Yes, watch number 73, the lineman Robert Lee gets in on his great block there, and that really gets the backer free. So then again, this offensive line is doing a good job, and then Lee comes in and gives him an extra push at the very end.
That was just about Tariq Lewis wanting it more than the other player.
Absolutely, and that's what it comes down to right now late in the fourth quarter.
Third and very short. Goddard will keep it himself into the pile. Pile moves, and I think he has the first down. He's out across the 35.
That's a good call. Why? Because Goddard is a big, strong, physical-type quarterback that you can use him as a running back. That was a design run. He knows, you're not going to break one deep here for, 70 yards. You know those linebackers are right there. He gets behind his big offensive lineman and makes sure he holds on to that ball. Good job by Robert Lee once again, pulling from left to right to lead the quarterback up for that first down.
You talk about Lee. He was the center last year, guard now, as you're seeing him out there. Another big first down, clock running under 5 minutes now. Deep and out of the 35-40, and a big gap at the midfield stripe and to the 46-yard line. And Clay gets a huge first down for Kirkwood.
great call by the offensive coordinator here. You've been pounding them up the middle, up the middle, up the middle. Now you hit them with the misdirection. Give it to them. Around the edge you go. Look at those linebackers. They're stuck in the middle. Then he breaks it free, gets to the second and third level, uses his speed, and wraps up the ball. Very good play call. Great execution by this offense.
Big first down, clock running, under 5 minutes. It'll be under 4.5 minutes by the time they snap it. And another sweep, this time this side. Inside the 40, 35, down near the 30-yard line. Did the ball come out? It did. And Parkway North has the turnover. What a turn of events. After a good run by Lewis, he coughed it up, and the Vikings come up with a crucial turnover.
Exactly what North needed. Boy, I thought that ground made him fumble. I thought he was on the ground. I'd like to see that again if we can. It's
well, look at
good
that.
Play call.
The guys in the truck are listening to you.
Good play call, and he gets around Clay with a good block right there to get him up. Now he needs to switch the ball from the left hand to the right hand, and he doesn't do that. And then he's in the air now.
Well, we're not going to see
and
it because of the tent.
Tent is right there in my way.
Jelani Williams was there reaching in for it, and probably Jelani pulled it out. And Parkway North needed a turnover in the worst way, and they got it. 4:21 to go. This might be their last opportunity. A little confusion in the backfield, but Suber runs hard and picks up 5, maybe 6 yards.
This Kirkwood defense is going to be asked one more time to have a good stand and to make sure that Nort doesn't get in the end zone.
I think we're going to see the fumble from a little bit different angle. Maybe that tent won't be in the way.
There's Lewis. He has the ball in his left hand. Now he's going to jump right here. Does he lose the ball in the air there?
Yeah, because the ball's way
back
at the 30-yard
line. Yeah, he did because the ball's
line.
Behind him. Absolutely, he lost
fumbled the snap. And Hertzler got on top of it. Wow, that could have been disaster for Parkway North. As it is, they cough up a down, and it'll be third and about 3 to get this crucial first down.
Whatever your best play-action play is to get the ball in the flat may be the call here.
Or that play with the fullback in the wing?
Absolutely. You may go back to that play where the fullback slips a block, gets out in the flat, gets the ball, and goes up the sideline. You need one of those types of plays because nothing in the passing game has worked all night for North.
Third and 3 for the Vikings, inside handoff. Lewis threw a hole and a first down. Big conversion for Parkway North as Lewis now for the second time has come up with a big first down conversion for them.
Absolutely. I thought maybe they'll throw it to
him. It's Ryan Smith. I keep calling him the other fullback. I apologize.
I thought maybe they'll throw it to him. Instead of doing that, they said, listen, we're just going to give it to you out of the backfield, get a good head of steam, and get that first down.
Under 3 minutes to go. A fresh set of downs for Parkway North. Ryan Smith has come up with 2 big plays in this fourth quarter. Pitch, Suber. Comes near side, 40, a flag comes in. He's across the 45 and fumbled, but Parkway North fell on it. Jelani Williams fell on it, so they didn't turn it over. Usually you think holding, and that's in fact what it is against Parkway North.
Yeah, the left guard, Michael Thompson, 6'4", 285. He had the shirt all balled up from Avril Ferguson.
Good look at the Kirkwood fans.
Easy holding call. He grabbed the shirt and just did not let it go.
That is a bad penalty for Parkway North.
Bad penalty at the absolute worst time. It's never a good time to have a penalty.
Right.
But when you are driving and trying to tie the game, that was absolutely a bad penalty.
Yeah, so I'm not blaming the player. I'm just saying the timing of that was just
absolutely
devastating.
Absolutely,
you know?
Absolutely.
All the way back to the 32-yard line. It's going to be first and a long way to go. Clock running, 2:25 to go. And don't forget, Parkway North has already used 2 of their timeouts. In the gun now, Hertzler. They might have to chuck it a little bit now. And Parkway North move. In just a moment, Isaac Bird will be naming your Carpenters Union player of the game, who I'm guessing it's number 9 in red. And we'll also be trying to figure out the Vetterot hard hat player of the game as well. False start moves it back 5 more yards, and it will cost them some time. This is becoming a crucial I mean, a very difficult time for Parkway North.
Absolutely. Now they're starting to make mistakes at the most crucial time in the game. Now you're under 3 minutes, under 2 minutes, only on your 26-yard line, and now their sense of urgency has to kick in with this offense.
Two straight penalties, and North needs a lot of yards as well. Back to pass and a reverse. McMiller has it deep and is going to lose a lot of yardage all the way back to the 16-yard line. Luke Moore was pursuing and made the tackle.
That's just being very disciplined. Luke Moore has the outside contained. It is his job as a defensive lineman to make. Watch him right here, number 11 on the top of your screen. He has outside contained. He must make sure he gets blocked and he gets up and he sees it. He must make sure he turns this run back in. Good job of reaching out, grabbing him, and making the tackle. That's just a great effort from a defender that was blocked, gets up, and makes the play.
Second and a mile after this play, I'm going to have you officially say that Reese Goddard is the Carpenters Union player of the game. Long pass left side, up for grabs, diving, and not able to pull it in for Parkway North. Incomplete to Hawkins. And yes, Reese Goddard, player of the game?
Absolutely, absolutely.
And Williams is hurt. He might have landed on his shoulder. He didn't look like he was moving that right arm very well when they tried to roll him over. And what about the veteran hard hat player of the game?
I like the safety from Kirkwood, Travion Mosby, who really had a good game. He had a lot of tackles. He's coming from his safety position. He had a couple of tackles behind the line of scrimmage. He broke up a couple of passes today, and he had at least one touchdown saving tackle. I thought he was all over the field and did an exceptional job as well tonight, right when his team needed to have a really big defensive performance. I thought coming from his safety position, he did a great job all night.
Williams will walk off and try to check on him later, Hawkins rather. But he doesn't look as badly injured as I initially thought. It's going to be third down and very long. Third and 32, it looks like, under a minute to go. And Parkway North is two plays left, one timeout left to try to get a first down and to try to kind of keep this game going. So you heard the announcement. Reese Goddard will be your Carpenters Union player of the game. And the safety, Travion Mosby, will be your Vatterott College hard hat player of the game. And third and very long for Parkway North. Twins to the bottom, trips to the top. They've got to get 32 yards in the next two plays and still have time to try to score a touchdown. Back to pass, Hertzler steps up, flag comes over the middle, intercepted. And a flag in the back end. And bringing it on cue is Mr. Mosby. Inside the 20 and down near the 15 will sort out the flags. But right after Isaac Bird said he was the hard hat player of the game, Mosby with a big interception.
Right where his team needed him. He's been there all night making plays. He's the safety. He has to make sure no one gets behind him. So he backpedals and reads the quarterback. Once that ball's in the air, now you have to be the receiver. He comes in and picks it off, comes right up under the receiver. And I see a flag there.
Well, it wasn't on him.
Can't be on him.
No, he made
it has
a great
to be
play.
Absolutely. It has to be something else.
You wonder if the one back at the back end was a roughing the passer. Now we'll watch. Here it is. It's holding against Parkway North. That's the first flag. And roughing the passer and interference?
Wow.
Anyway, we wipe off the whole play, and it's still third down. No interception for Mosby.
I guess they called Mosby for pass interference.
They called somebody for interference. He didn't touch the receiver.
I didn't see the entire play, the entire route. He may have been pushed while the ball was in the air by one of the corners before Mosby was able to get to the ball. But that's the problem that Parkway North has in this situation. They got to try to throw the ball deep. But Travion Mosby is one of those ball-hawking safeties where if that ball lays in the air too much, he's got the speed and athletic ability to cover from numbers to numbers to pick that ball off.
41 seconds left in the game. Parkway North on life support, rolling away Hertzler, and he's going to be sacked, fumbled, picked up out of the air, and run into the end zone by Telfair. A defensive touchdown by Kirkwood after the sack, the fumble, and the touchdown by Taj Telfair.
That puts an exclamation point right there on this game. And this is a huge win for Kirkwood right here at their home field. Big, big win.
Watch it again. Telfair comes in, forces him out of the pocket. Going to get hit from behind here. And Telfair comes up with the loose ball. Give the sack to big number 71, Cortland Roseman. And then Telfair with the score.
Yeah, I think that was actually Cameron Torr who actually got the sack. Number 71. Great play, big play by Kirkwood. Just a huge play. This defense all day long has dominated. Right when they needed a big game defensively, they get it.
Watch it again. Telfair will force him outside. Then the pursuit comes.
There's 71. Good hit. Wraps him up. Very good legal hit. Wraps him up. And he gets up and jumps up because he knows that was going to be a touchdown. And he's the one that calls that play. That's defense has been exceptional all night.
That's Telfair's third fumble recovery of the year in five games. Scores the touchdown. They lead it 12-0 and obviously ends any hope that Parkway North has to win this game. Kirkwood going to maintain that his winning streak. Lost their opening game to Chaminade, but they've been perfect since then. And Williams on for the extra point. It's up high long enough, and this one is good. They lead it 13-0 with 34 seconds to go. Slow to get up is the offensive lineman Lee.
Well, North just never was able to sustain any type of ground game. We in a tough game like this with the weather being so bad, the passing game really goes out of the window. Kirkwood made one big play in the running game that got them their lead, and their defense was able to hold on. Parkway North was not able to sustain any type of ground game. And when they turned to the pass today, it was just not there at all.
A lot of discussion on the Kirkwood sideline. They're up two scores with 34 seconds to go. There's not a whole lot to think about here. Squib the kick down there, make them run it around. They're not going to score twice in the next 34 seconds.
I guess they were probably talking about maintain your, don't celebrate too much too early.
Let's don't go jump on the field. Don't everybody get excited. Sure, all those discipline things.
Sure.
And now Nick Williams gets ready to put a foot into it. You would think squib, and there is the squib at about the 30-yard line. Coming all the way to the near side, big block there across the 40, cut down at about the 42.
Guess who?
Yeah, your guy. Mr. Mosby with the open field hit, and Parkway North has a play or two left, and that will be it. And how about those Kirkwood Pioneers played manly defense tonight?
Absolutely. The entire night facing a very good, strong offense, a strong quarterback who was able to make some plays all year. This team of Kirkwood coming to this game, having put up a lot of points against good opponents. They don't put up a lot of points tonight. But this defense really, really showed up right when they needed it.
Kirkwood will roll to 2-0 in the league. Parkway North will fall to 1-1. So the Pioneers also take a leg up. Rittner 1-0. They will, haven't played tonight. But Kirkwood will. Oh, there's a fumble. And it's loose. And it looks like Kirkwood has the ball. It's all moot at this point. The game was going to end anyway.
It is moot, but now Kirkwood gets the opportunity to get into the best formation in all of football. That's what it's about, being in that formation, the victory formation.
Pioneers will go to 2-0 in the league and have the most wins in conference play in the Suburban 12 South standings. And here comes Isaac's favorite formation.
Love this formation.
13-0 is going to be your final score. Two teams playing in not great conditions. Goddard will take the 5-yard loss. You'd rarely see the victory formation in a shotgun.
They just wanted to make sure that snap didn't get bobbled. It's a wet ball. They wanted to make sure they just get it back to Goddard and let him go ahead and sit on it.
Pioneers have won 4 in a row. They're 4-1. First loss of the year for Parkway North. Let's send it to Angela. She has our hard hat player of the game, Mr. Mosby.
I have our veteran hard hat player of the game, Mr. Mosby. All right, what was it like out there in the rain?
Well, in the rain, you just gotta play hard, you know. The rain didn't bother me at all. I played like it was 80 degrees out there.
Didn't affect you one bit. Now, you guys started a little bit slow. You had a couple bad starts up there. How did you guys pull it together?
Well, we was in the locker room, and we said, don't let the weather determine how we play. So second half, we came out and just played our heart out.
And I love how everybody's coming. I'm interviewing him. Everybody's over here congratulating the other. What does this win mean for you guys? What do you go into next week with?
Well, 0-0. We just got to play the next team and beat them. We just on the road to stay. That's all, man.
That's right. Well, we have the Vatterod hard hat for you right here. You're the hard hat player of the game. Thank you very much. Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
All right. Thank you, Angela. Reese Goddard standing by. So no doubt we'll be sending it right back to Angela. And she has our Carpenters Union player of the game, quarterback Reese Goddard.
I have our Carpenters District Union player of the game, Mr. Goddard. Now, you've been doing a lot of media recently. You beat a record.
Yeah. Last week. All because of my line and receivers. My receivers took it for about 300 yards after catch, thanks to all of them and the line blocking in front of me.
No, I noticed that. I saw one of your interviews, and you said right after you realized you broke that record, you thanked them for catching that.
Because, I mean, I could not have done it without them, no doubt. And they did that for me. And it was a record as a team, not just a single individual record.
Well, I love that. Now, what was today like? I mean, steady rain all day. What was that like for you? Slippery ball, that kind of thing.
We knew inclement weather would be there since yesterday, so we practiced a little with the wet ball. We went into it knowing we wouldn't be able to throw that much, so we really had to rely on our running game. But in the end, it was our defense that won the game. Our whole defense should be getting interviewed because they allowed 0 points against a really good team.
I love this because you keep deflecting the compliments I'm giving you to other people on your team. Is Kirkwood just a big team effort here?
Yes, all in. Our motto is all in. We're all in as a team.
We love it. Well, you are our Carpenters District Union player of the game. Thank you very much. And what are you going to take into next week?
We have a bye week next week, so some rest, ice, and prepare for Parkway South in 2 weeks.
All right, well, good luck to you. Thank you very much. You. Back to you, Harry and Isaac.
There you see the final score, Kirkwood over Parkway North, 13-0 in the soggy E.L. Lions field here at Kirkwood High School. That'll do it for us, for our sideline reporter, Angela Sharp, all the guys and gals that are running the equipment and standing in the rain while Isaac and I stay in the nice dry press box. We want to say, since you've been there, make it a better place. So glad you've been with us tonight at Kirkwood High School. 13-0 is your final score. We say goodnight to you from Kirkwood, from the Bommarito Automotive Group Prep Zone High School Game of the Week.